Liz Adal, MA Connect TV, and I'm here at Team Rhino headquarters in Finglas with Paul Redzer Redmond. And we're just going to catch up with Paul, talk about his upcoming fight at Bantam 6. What story?
Yeah. Oh, we're just trying away. Just cut the tail end of that training session there, so yeah, that's good.
Looking forward to this?
Yeah, can't wait to get back in there. It's been a long road, sort of, between BAM having the pull the show back. I was matching a show in England. BAM gave me a foot release. And I started the year, we were negotiating different contracts and stuff, just to get me back in. So the long road between, like, from now to when I was in last in the cage, you know, by the time, I think it's about 18 months, you know, it's a long time.
So for anyone that knows anything about BAM, especially the shows coming up, you've changed opponents?
Yeah, a couple of changed opponents. There was Jack McGann, I know he got signed to the Russian promotion. He's fighting a couple of good guys over there, you know. He gave me a text or tweet, just said best of luck, so, you know, wish him all the best over there, hope he does really well, you know. And then, yeah, Chris Trina jumped in the drop. I think there was another opponent in there that fell through, and then Chris jumped on it. Yeah.
Does it matter?
No, me, I don't badmouth anybody. I just take the fights as they come, you know. I do this sport because I enjoy it, like, not because I hate anyone, not because I slag anyone or feel I have to badmouth anyone. I'm just getting in because I like doing it, you know.
Yeah, yeah. So there's a couple of lads that obviously you're collaborating with that are on the panel as well. What's the mood like, you know, coming up to us?
Yeah, really good. Anytime there's more room for it on the show, there's always good buzz around the gym. And anyway, you know, just we don't take ourselves too seriously down here, you know, in terms of, we like to joke around and stuff, but in terms of competition, you know, with anyone that competes, and that, you know, we give it 100%, but the gym atmosphere is super relaxed, you know.
And arguably, you know, BAM are one of the biggest promotions in Europe, and, you know, coming to Ireland, it's always a big event. Have you been speaking to people, you know, punters that are coming to the show,
looking
forward to it, you know?
No? I just, you know, yeah, I wake up in the morning, I grab a coffee with the lads, I come here, I train, I go home, I sleep for an hour, come back here, train, go home, sleep for an hour. I might teach one or two classes during the week, but that's sort of me. That's it. I'm sort of, I'm like a little nomad, I am, I just keep myself to myself, you know, lately. I just get stuck in training, you know, and I'm enjoying it. I was away in Vegas with the lads, the Team Ireland coaching over there and stuff, you know, so that's my sort of little getaway. Otherwise, I'm never out of the gym, you know.
Well, that's reason why we're here, to do the Bantam 6 promo, but also to catch up with the lads and find out about the IMAP trial that started taking place at Battles on this weekend.
Yeah.
What was it like for you in Vegas? I know there was a lot of, you know, tweets and a lot of good vibes coming back to us, reports with you, you know, everyone was singing your praise about how good you were coaching.
It's a thing I definitely like doing, you know. I like going out and cornering the lads and being around that atmosphere, you know. It's good that I can give some sort of advice to the younger lads coming through, and even some of them are just as old as me, like, going into the amateur, but, you know, I've been sort of around a long time, so if I can give any advice to them, and it takes them away from going into a fight and winning the fight, you know, it's great. But we had a great time over there. Team Ireland took the biggest medal haul in the world, so we're super pleased with that. Gold, two silvers, and three bronzes, so yeah.
And Team Ireland's Matthew taking on gold.
Yeah, Big Matt. He was actually doing the dog on, and he hadn't fought in a long time, ago, 2 years, I think. And I think he's only ever had one, maybe two amateur fights before that. He just went in, listened to everything, and just, whatever we asked him to do with him in the cage, sometimes it's a little bit hard in the time before in the cage, the adrenaline toy and stuff like that, or the mind period and stuff, and really good, you asked the guy to do, he just stuck to it like glue, hats off to him, he was just like a soldier over there, he was.
Is the IMAP trials or the IMAP
European
Games or the World, is that something that you would encourage younger amateurs to get involved in?
Yeah, 100%, you know, and saying that now, the competition, it's really tough, and I think it actually sets it up. If you do those competitions a lot, it sets you up for a good pro career. Like, Matty had five or maybe six fights in the whole week, so five fights, sorry, you fight once every day. There's guys going in there with, like, big cuts, you know, taped up bandages on the arm and stuff, you know, so you can come off the end of that and still win, and want to go even though you're broke up and stuff like that. You know, that's a pro career, is definitely the right, I think it separates the men from the boys, you know.
Well, listen, I know you're eager to get home.
I don't mind chances when he's come out. I just need to be a bit comfy sometimes, you know.
A little bit.
Okay.
But listen, I'll let you go, and we'll see you in 2 weeks. Yeah,
next
take it easy. And thanks for appreciating it, Paul Redmond. Bama 26, September 10th.